Hi, this is Dan Harrison from Pool & Spa TV. Today we're on Long Island in New York to show you where people put hot tubs.
Hi, we're in Setauket, and we're going to be talking to Ron Kerner. This is one of the nicer rooms that we've done. You can see it here in the background. We'll be taking a look at that in a second, but let's go inside and meet Ron right now because he's done some really nice things to this house. There's nice cedar work here that was also done a couple months after the room was taken care of. Certainly hope that he's going to be here. And there he is.
Hey, how you doing, Ron?
Okay, how are you?
Good, how are you, Seth?
Just brought the television world.
Very good.
Take a look at your hot tub.
Come on in.
Well, I see that you've done a lot of different things here with the house since you put the room on.
Yes, that used to all be a solid wall.
This was also Steve Busa's room, right?
Steve Busa's
carpentry passion.
Exactly correct.
When you, I mean, there's certainly a lot going on in here other than your hot tub. Mm-hmm. When you came to him, did you tell him specifically what you wanted?
Well, only some of that. We sat down and kicked around a few ideas. Actually, during the course of this thing's construction, we altered plans and changed things. For example, the stone wall here, that wasn't going to be stone, that was just going to be wood. But Steve came up with the idea and incorporated it.
Was that a very expensive option to add to the
Not door? Particularly. It was really quite reasonable.
But this is something that a lot of people see the pictures of this job and they're always drawn to this this room. Your room has been the inspiration for probably hundreds of hot tub rooms on Long Island here. What you have here is, this is a Monte Carlo, right? Mm-hmm. This is an in-ground system. How do you use the tub? Do you find that you often have six people in the tub with you, or is it normally yourself, or you and your wife?
Mostly my wife and myself, and occasional parties a couple of times a year, about five, six people running around here.
If you had it to do over again, would you have gotten a bigger tub, a smaller tub?
No, this was just fine. This was a perfect size.
Now this sunroom here, I see you have a lot of light that comes in the wall. Does this help you to heat your house, this room?
Well, if you notice in the walls, right built into the stonework, are grills which have fans inside of them. There's one there and one over there.
Really?
And today the house is being heated entirely by the sun.
So that sucks the air out that way.
Exactly.
So regardless of whether or not the hot tub actually has its cover on, it's the heat from the sun is what you're pulling in.
This is exactly correct.
Right.
In fact, the hot tub doesn't heat it at all.
Now, I also notice you have an exhaust fan up here.
Mm-hmm.
Is this, so this you use when you're using the hot tub?
That's correct. That will take out a lot of moisture in the air.
This is a total in-ground system that you have here. So your equipment is in a remote location?
Right.
Where is that?
That's in the basement.
Can we go take a look at that?
If you like.
Let's go take a look at that.
This is your propane tank?
That's it.
So you have a gas liquid propane heater.
That's you.
This is where the equipment is.
This is where we have our pack of equipment for the spa. And the hosing runs across the length of half the basement over into the room.
This is your gas heater here. You have a 50 square foot filter. Well, that might even be a big one. 50 square foot. This is your deluxe super pump.
Right, that's the 2 horsepower.
2 horsepower.
Right.
And your blower, you have your timer box
all
here.
All the timer and everything.
Your venting for the gas, and then, right, yeah, all your pipes go over to the back there. Well, that's great. It's convenient that you had this spot to be able to do this.
Well, we created this spot. I mean, this was wall and incredibly hard packed.
So this is the outside of your room here. This is all cedar, what they did?
All cedar. Somewhat in need of a little treatment again for the
spring. It juts up here. This is where, so you have the backlighting coming
down?
That's
correct.
Because that's something that we show a lot of people. They don't understand why anyone would do that. But then when we show them the inside pictures,
exactly. Originally we thought of just extending the roof line down.
Right.
It was sort of conventional spa room construction.
And you have a door over here.
There's a door over
now,
here.
Now, I noticed when we were inside, you have a chair in front of there, which means you probably don't often walk out of here.
I don't.
Oh, glad to hear that you're happy with it.
Thank you very much for letting us come by. Maybe you'll let us come over and use your tub one of these
nights.
Hey,
why not?
Now, off to another hot tub room.
Well, we hope that this video gave you some ideas as to where you could put your own hot tub. My name is Dan Harrison from Pool & Spa TV, and make sure you tune in to our next episode where you could see where people put hot tubs.